Okay, here's another one of those wonderful times when I played the game for almost an hour. This was originally an hour-long video, and I did not have my microphone turned on, so I rambled forever for no reason.
Hey.
Let's see, what are we doing? I think we're giving her some water here. The plan here was to head on down. Oh, we were going to try the sharpshooter's blaster trick with her. Yeah, one more time. Yeah, she, see, on the old Fallouts, as long as you gave your companions a weapon and one round of ammunition, they could use that weapon. Now, there's supposed to be a trick where if you give them a 5mm round, they could use almost any weapon, but it doesn't seem to work with the fancy-dancy ones like the alien blaster. So what I tried doing was the old trick here with the alien blaster and one round of alien blaster stuff. It doesn't work. I'm going to tell you right now. She shoots one round of alien blaster and then goes back to her 10mm. Which is a pity, because if you could set that up, if you could get it where she had unlimited alien blaster rounds, I could just walk around, you know, just watching the stuff die. But here, we're trying to get, you know, do another water run. We got, you know, a good over 300 water, usually around 350 to 400 being cranked out here in the sanctuary. Which I still don't understand why that doesn't, like, where you can't get that same water from any workshop, because I've got the whole supply lines going. Now, if you're wondering what we're doing here, I'm trying to get her to get inside this power armor, which for some reason put me in the power armor, but the plan here is to
head over there.
Right there.
Go there.
Now I'm trying to exit, but it's telling Piper to go, and I'm like, what the? There we go. It's a little bit touchy because they use E for so many things. Now, you there.
Hey.
Sexy, get in the darned suit of armor.
That's a plan.
It's the plan, but are you going to do the plan? Now, I'm going to take this pumped up, not pumped up so much. There's only so much you can do with it. This raider armor. Did do a couple of drills to it, but I figured this looked like I gave her the stylish arm. Now, for some reason, it gave priority to her hat that gives her +2 to endurance. So I guess that just means that was the better mix of statistics for her, and better statistics than you you'll have this. Now we're going to fast travel to the market here, sell off our water, get some ammunition, and then walk from there to the Warwick Homestead, which I'm expecting at this point in the endeavor to be a complete annoyance. And depending on which way you go, yeah, it kind of is. There's a lot of weird things that happened here. You get to see weirdness. Right now, you're just going to stare at this luck bobblehead. We go here. Boopity, boopity, boopity. I'm still... Oh, gee, I didn't mean to cut you off there, especially since you can't hear me.
Heads up.
Don't mind the clutter.
Okay, I'm going to try and set off as many of these waters as I can. Even in the power suit, it's just so many gurgling gallons of water.
You
give me bullets.
Protection. Everyone does.
I'm in a suit of armor.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Everything hand tool.
Just give me bullets, give me bullets, give me bullets, give me bullets. So many bullets. I don't even have a 50 cal. Buy me bullets. Someday when I get a 50 caliber weapon, it'll be like, wow. Yeah, I'd love to buy the big boy. We're not there yet. Cryosills. Which if I have found out that the cryosill thing, that's just really wonderful. Old Faithful, I should look at that. I wonder what that is. Probably like a lever action rifle or something, but you know. I don't think it's a water gun.
Hope you didn't run into any trouble, Ken. That bridge across the river.
Let's just completely ignore Nat, the poor thing. You just abandoned to sell papers while we just, you know, wander around. Of course, I'm completely ignoring my missing son while we sell water and try to help homesteads, you know. It's the way of the world, you know, you just say the hell with it out here. Although I gotta say, I'm starting to get to the point where I, you know, my plan is working of just maintaining the homesteads and then, you know. It's tricky because right now I'm getting just enough water to constantly keep bolstering homesteads and buying ammo to keep meeting the missions. So I'm maintaining myself. I'm not getting ahead, and I really need to get a little bit ahead so that I can follow the main course here, the main storyline. Which again, I'm not hot on the ending of it. I won't do any spoilers here, but I mean, I'm not impressed. Everybody knows it for the most part, but. And let's see, a good weapon. What do we want to shoot? The sword, that's kind of a waste of time because, you know, I have so much armor right now, it probably is weakened it to nothing. Don't think we need the rocket launcher just yet. Night vision, powerful. At least we can look around. We'll be able to scout here in the evening. Now, I didn't notice this. I didn't notice that guy taking aim. Over that way. Well, I would have walked that way. This way, we're just saying the heck with it. We're walking up this way. The one thing I noticed. You know, the Trinity Tower radio signal phone. That's. Do we switch to a different weapon here? What are we doing? I had the napalmer. Haven't used that much yet. But, I mean, the atmosphere on this is just perfect. I mean, this is just gloomy, ruined, sad. Nothing good going on here. At some point, you'll see me using the map a little less because what I actually did was I actually used my Pip-Boy app on the phone, and it worked really nice. It went well. Keep your head on a swivel out here. You don't know what's going to come at you. Trying to get to that main road. Can't jump over the fence here. Looks like there's a subway or something down there. We don't want to be involved in that. We're on a mission. We want to get to the Warwick Homestead. Can't even jump over the. Okay, we'll have to go around the sign. And now this is interesting because notice that the rads are picking up a little bit, and there's a giant hole. So this is probably the location where the bomb hit Boston. At least one of the bombs that hit Boston. There's a couple other places, you know, there, that I found that look like, yeah, that's a. You'll see in a couple videos that there's a big glowing hole out on the far side of the map.
Message to all Commonwealth Army soldiers. Emergency protocols 17 Echo Charlie Niner are in effect. If you are in distress, please proceed to the South Boston Military Checkpoint for aid. Coordinates are available in your emergency handbook.
We'll just listen to this for a little bit.
This checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently stocked with additional food, water, and ammunition.
So that's a hint that there's a cache you can get to if you can find it, probably.
This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens, including non-military family members, will be turned away for matters of national safety.
And what did it matter, right?
Repeat.
It's probably right around there. And we'll make a note of that. We'll head back at some point. J. Gotta get all the way around there.
This is an emergency message to all Commonwealth Army soldiers. Emergency protocols 17 Echo Charlie Niner are in effect. If you are in distress, please proceed to the South Boston Military Checkpoint Parade.
If you're in distress.
Are available in your emergency handbook.
I love the, and I commented on this the first time going around. I love that the atmosphere that lends it.
This checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently stocked with additional food, water, and ammunition.
You say, well, you held the batteries hold up for 200 years. Well, they're nuclear batteries.
This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens, including non-military family members, will be turned away for matters of national safety.
Right now I'm like, where the heck is Pipes?
This Piper. Message will repeat.
I'm like, okay, she'll catch up. I could take the main road, or I could go straight. And, I think I chose to take the main road here, and that was a dumb idea.
This is an emergency message to all Commonwealth Army soldiers. Emergency protocols 17 Echo Charlie Niner are in effect.
It made sense at the time. You'd think to keep the main road, you should stay away from the interesting kind of trouble spots.
If you are in distress, please proceed to
the South Boston
Military Checkpoint Parade. Coordinates are available in your emergency handbook.
We're just gonna... we went to avoid him. I don't remember exactly how things went here, but they went badly. I think we come across Cricket.
This checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion, and is currently
that seemed like a trap.
Food, water, and ammunition. This safe house is for military personnel only. Citizens, including non-military family members, will be turned away for matters of national safety.
It's just gloomy and doomy and unhappy. Jamaica Plain. Okay, I can see I'm drifting too far over here and I gotta bring it back. Yeah, I don't think I was. Maybe this might have been the point I started using the Pip-Boy. I'm not sure. The Pip-Boy app. Oddly enough, I haven't actually used the Pip-Boy itself here, and I am one of the luckiest ones who have an actual Pip-Boy, but... it's not as convenient as you might think. Just having the phone kind of leaning up against the monitor is a lot better as a second string experience. Trying to avoid as much combat as possible because I just want to save my ammunition. I mean, that's my whole thing right now. It's really a resource thing. Should have gone through the mud. I don't know what I'm trying to do there. Can't okay, there's enemies about, I know that much. Yeah, I was trying to see what the hell that was. Okay, this is an interesting location that we've got. And it's unmarked. Nothing really came up there. And yet, you got a power armor station here. Stuff. I don't know why I can't grab that, but you can't. There's a human head on a grill. Which is a way, the game's way of telling you, this isn't a happy place. I'm going completely the wrong direction at this point. So I probably hadn't thought of using the Pip-Boy yet. I'm thinking, oh god, this can't be good. Quincy Corey's, that might be the one where you actually fire the mini nuke in the beginning. There's another quarry near Sanctuary, where you get the mission to try and clear the pipes. And I'm not doing that until I get the Aqua Boy perk. But this was a critical mistake, because then it takes me straight through the bad part of town, as I recall. Yeah, still hadn't gone to using the Pip-Boy yet. I think somewhere around here, I was flipping back and forth so much that it came to me that, you know, maybe you should use something a little different. As I double check to make sure my mic is turned on this time. Yes, it is. It's not blinking. All right, we're...
Most folks are just looking for a hand. All we gotta do is offer.
What folks? And I hope you're not finding anyone at this point. In case you're curious, this is not a happy place here. And I want to comment again, this is like, people were kind of worried that, I remember when the first screenshots came out of Fallout 4, they said, oh, it's going to be too pleasant because it had blue skies and all kinds of different color palette stuff going to it. Okay, anybody worried still that it's going to be a happy game? Radioactive swamps. I love how the meters work. This is where things gonna go wrong, as I recall. This is a place you do not enter unless you have a suit of power armor, which I do. Quincy Ruins and the Quincy, unless you're pretty geared up. You got lots of ammo, nothing better to do with your time. And that's what, artillery? There's a battle going on here, and I don't even know who the sides are. Oh, yep, this is where it all gets interesting. Cricket. I thought she was injured.
Hankering for a melting face? I'm your girl.
Let's see what you got.
A part of every big purchase goes to planting little bitty trees that I'll blow up in your honor.
That was extremely funny, and... Buy a little ammo... Just to, you know, cut her some slack.
Just like that.
I think I decided, just because I thought Cricket was in danger, to rush in here and try and go through.
Company.
Clint. He's got a gamma-enhanced laser. Different weapon. Yeah, that didn't work out well. Pumped a couple out there. That's how tough the gunner private here just took a missile right in the abdomen. So now I just take off. Saying, alright, if you're taking a missile to the abdomen, I need some room here to do some long range stuff.
Hey, go check that out.
Inspector Guru, I'm trying to get her to come to me. That looks like some serious armor. He's dancing around where you can't get to him. That might be Enclave armor. I can't even really tell. This is where you come when you become bored with the game. And probably not before then. I'm like, I think we are way outgunned here. I hit him, and that didn't seem to do anything. You think you're mad? Well, let's.
You think we're safe now?
No.
Better in our hands anyway.
I concur. At this point, as I'm watching the game, I'm thinking switch to a close quarters weapon. Dead settler. Cut through here. Chain activate. Okay, so we have to open this door. Oh, great. So now I'm trying to do something here. This is the armor piercing weapon. Maybe that's where I'm I'm trying to think if I clipped Piper at some point here. Look at this. I mean, it's just clip after clip. Take. Incidentally, I don't have this currently. It's. He's wearing leather. I'm shooting him in the face with armor-piercing ammo. Thinking I gotta work away from here in the right direction. And back through the chain link fence where I went. Yes, I'm just running away. Don't see her. Oh, good, the music stopped. Still wondering what the heck happened to her. Thinking that's what happened to her. At this point, I'm thinking, what's going on here? Do I have to fast travel to pick her up again? Is she down? I think can hug the water. Stay away from the big light lit up building, which is probably full of unhappy people. Most of my armor is destroyed. I can barely see anything for the night and the fog. My companion is... I mean, you're not supposed to. You're not supposed to be able to die in this game, the companions. Although, they say in the... the new survival mode, when the DLC comes out, they're updating survival mode, and if you go into survival mode, you can get your companions killed off. That's one of the new updates. Just a note. Also, there's no fast travel. You can only save if you're out of bed. And that's on top of you can get diseases, you can, you know... Stim packs and all that don't probably do a lot more reasonable health healing, which is not that much. So you need doctors more often. I don't know what I'm looking for here. We're almost there, but don't get your hopes up because things take a turn here pretty soon. I have no idea what I'm looking for here. Not a clue. I don't know what I was thinking. It's one of those things that's lost to the mist of time since the last time I was recording with the mic turned off. Silly mute button. Why do you need a mute button on a mic anyway? Okay, let's not look at that. Let's not look at that even a little bit. Let's go around. Still, all this time, no sign of Piper, and we're here, believe it or not. The Warwick Homestead. Now, he's got the location. That was the goal. Figure I'll fast travel over someplace. I remember when I was doing... I didn't see this during the combat, but I remember there was at least one point when I button-mashed something and it said send Piper to, like, another location. And it said Piper didn't like that. So I figured I'd fast travel here. I think I ended up stopping the game and going back, watching the video... and seeing where did I send her. Something along those lines. So that might have been what happened there. I might have paused and kicked in and out and said, oh, she's in Sanctuary. I do remember finding her in Sanctuary. And it doesn't go well. Wait, and watch this. Here we are. I'm like trying to... Yeah, alright, we'll just store our stuff and try and find pipes. Look and see, hey, did we at least get some water in the meantime? Yeah, there's water.
You gotta have something there you don't really need.
Think we're safe now? Okay, so she's kind of glitched out there, and now it's like, hello? Excuse me? She's gone hostile. Whatever happened to, friendly status here?
Hey,
There's not much I can do here. I'm loaded down with water. Trying to talk to her. She's smacking me in the head. Let's go back to one of the last loads. Yeah, see how there's a couple saves there? That's where I went and checked to see, saw where she went. Load something here already, make a decision. So I'm trying to figure out why, if it was just a glitch at that moment. Here's a set of armor that's under repair. Isn't it pretty? Side note, what do you think is the more iconic armor? The T-45, the T-51? The Enclave armor. Okay, so we went back here. And so I couldn't be normal that, you know, if maybe it was some kind of glitch where I, because I took the water, that somehow triggered something. That's a fairly unattractive pistol, I think. I don't know. It's, I guess that's supposed to be for better heat transfer, but I mean, you know, I don't know if that would work. Be a really heavy gun. Maybe for stability. First, the bluing's all worn the heck on it, so maybe if it was properly blued. Alright, we're back. Now let's hope. Maybe I get out of my armor. Just relax for a little bit. Now, where'd she go? See, she's not even here. So I'm thinking to myself at this point, maybe I'm okay. Let's take a look around. There's the dog. Still don't see her.
Yeah?
That's my provisioner, okay. As you can see here, still the state of my mini water production facilities and a lot of automatic guns. Trying to look out through the fog and figure out where the heck she went. Oh, there we go. This isn't good. So she's gone permanently hostile on me. And at some point, you'll see this kind of quits out. I'm interested to see if the guns would have turned on her. This makes me think, you know, if she's that volatile with this relationship, you know, maybe we don't want to date, because, I mean, if she's just going to start shooting at me when I send her home, that's... I didn't see in the combat at any point when I might have shot her, which I can understand that. I can kind of understand if she's annoyed. I still don't know, is this a glitch or is this something I did wrong? At this point, I know I did switch out and looked it up, and like once she's gone hostile, you're pretty well screwed. So that means, all of everything you just saw, after we bought our ammunition and went all the way to Warwick Homestead, completely wasted. Yep, had to do it over. Yeah. I was not a happy camper. New. And I'm a little sad that you've missed out on some of the reactions I had in the game when the emotions were a little higher, as opposed to watching it all like a movie. But Noob, not a happy camper. Just staring at this ugly bug, waiting for the game to load at this point, I'm thinking. Ironic that a thing on luck would come up, because I wasn't feeling hardly lucky there. So, we start over again with a companion that doesn't want to kill me. And this time, luckily enough, I did take a little more boring track, so we can actually skip ahead here a little bit.
Boston Military Checkpoint Parade.
We still went up the hill. Here, we still went up over the highway.
Please proceed to the South Boston Military Checkpoint Parade.
But this time,
available in your emergency handbook.
We kept things a little bit more out of the way. We tried to stay as far away.
Checkpoint has been designated as a safe house in case of enemy invasion.
From Quincy as possible.
This safe house is for military personnel only.
As you see, we really hug the coast.
Non-military family members will be turned away for matters of national safety.
Okay, University Point didn't do much exploration here, but at least it was a fast travel point if something went horribly wrong. I think I tried to go around the water side, but you couldn't.
This is an emergency message to
all
cut to
the inside.
Army soldiers. Emergency protocols 17 Echo Charlie Niner are in effect.
Ah, here we go. Okay, we'll keep it to the side with the water. Switch back to the night vision scope. I think I saw actually something move over that way. At least I thought I did. Yeah, so, alright, let's keep moving. I can hear the war going on over in Quincy. And I'm like, oh, this is just great. Rubble. Hoping not to get close enough to anything that's really interesting. And this time I said, alright, let's see what the heck's in here. We might as well, because it seemed like the only way we could avoid the mess to the right. Don't know what that place is. Didn't light anything up, so it's kind of an unmarked location. Give it a couple of thoughts. Look around. Not sure if the mic's gonna pick that up, but my son is currently laughing his head off over Elmo and Grouchland. So, highly recommend that if you have kids. This is real life gaming here, you know. It's even some of these YouTube guys, they have studios and stuff like that now. Oh, I remember this. This was like, hey, I got an idea. Let's cut through the water, and then we won't have to deal with any enemies. You see where this is going? Yeah. Then I remembered, oh, this isn't a fully automatic weapon. I need a fully automatic armor piercing. Just watch this thing eat ammo while it tries to eat me. It's just really great. It's a surreal experience on this end, because on the one hand, I'm being eaten alive by Mycleric hunters, and my son's laughing hysterically, which is kind of funny. But I'm not nearly as funny as Elmo. Okay. Luckily I saved right before that debacle and I said the hell with this. And made the point of switching to the right weapon this time. So stay near the water, stay away from the people, and yet don't get eaten by Mike-Lurk stuff. Okay, that's the plan now. Stay away from creepy old houses. Certainly stay away from all of that as much as possible. I mean, you gotta get past it. And I'm thinking, what's the best way here? Get completely wrapped up in the combat. One or two battles I can see. See, hop from garbage pile to garbage pile, debris to debris, slog it through, eat some radiation, but. Better than dealing with several death's head enemies. Suck down a little rat away, pop another stim pack. Again, stay away from everything that looks halfway interesting here. Okay, I'm looking at them thinking, do I want to deal with the red rocket thing? And that one? I wonder if that's the Adam Cat's lodge. Can't really get where I'm going. Going across the water. That's where I need to get. That's good to know. And you're not shooting me, which is even better. Okay, if we only stay clear of the big glowy building. Could have stealthed it, I guess. That would tell me if I'm being detected or not. Crouch down. We're almost there. Still don't know what's up on that big boat. And I mean, to this day, I still don't know what's on that big boat. At some point, we'll have to figure that out. When I'm in an exploratory mode. It looks impressive, which makes me think I'd have to invest a lot of ammunition in it. Can cut the tension with a knife. At what point will I just eat a mini nuke? But by some miracle. Pipes is not hostile with me. She's here. She's not dead. She's not incapacitated. And we once again have made it to the Warwick Homestead.
That's really nice of you.
Excuse me.
Don't think I've seen you around here before. You new to these parts?
Yeah, it's my first time here.
In that case, welcome. We're always happy to have guests here at Warwick Homestead. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why set up a farm at a place like this? It might not look like much. And there's that smell. But that's the thing. See, this used to be a sewage plant. The most fertile soil in the Commonwealth is right under our feet.
No wonder your crops are doing so well.
Yep. They really are.
Now, this is a big moment.
I feel lucky to even be having this conversation.
So we've
fell on some hard times not long ago. A pack of super mutants hit us. Wrecked our entire crop. Used to be the Minutemen would have helped us out, but last I heard, they were too busy fighting each other to worry about us farmers. So we were on our own. All of us starving, near to death. No man should have to watch his wife and children suffer.
Now that's an interesting point. There's a justification there.
Those days are over. The Minutemen are back, and we won't let you down again.
If that's true, I'm glad to hear it, because we still need help. Those super mutants are still out there somewhere, and they could come back at any time. I know it's a lot to ask, but if you put an end to them, we'll all sleep a little easier.
Do you know where they're coming from?
We have a pretty good idea. I hope you can find them and wipe them out.
Okay, so now we've been idolized by Pyro, which is like the whole point, because now we'll get the perk. The Gift of Gab perk.
Just let me know.
Hey, Piper.
So, you've found a minute for me yet?
Something up?
Well, yeah, but it's nothing bad. Just what you said about Nat. I've been going over it again and again in my head, and what you said was right. Family's too precious. What kind of life is she gonna have if I never go near her again? It's just, sometimes it feels like the only things I've got in life are Nat and the paper. Having someone I can count on, someone like you, it's meant a lot to me. Not a lot of people want to hang around with the nosy reporter.
Yeah, but you're my kind of nosy.
You're the exception. I haven't exactly made a lot of friends in this career. I just wanted to right the things I thought were wrong. And when Nat and I first got to Diamond City, there was a lot of wrong. Crooked guards, lousy infrastructure. There was a hole in the exterior wall that was patched over with a bookcase. One bookcase. That's it. I started the paper more as an act of desperation than anything else. Turned out I wasn't the only one who wanted things to change. After the first couple of editions, people may not have agreed with what I said, but everyone was listening.
Sounds like you really cleaned up Diamond City.
Well, a lot of things got done. They even put a second bookshelf over that hole and patched it with bricks. When that first edition hit the stands, I felt like I'd finally done something worth doing. But afterwards, things changed. People didn't want to talk the way they used to. It seemed that overnight I'd gone from being Piper, friend and confidant, to Piper, the nosy snoop. A lot of folks, they haven't treated me the same since. Started to feel like the only person I could count on was my little sis.
You can count on me, Piper.
I know I can. You're not afraid of me like everyone else. I was sure that the paper would be the best thing I ever did in my life, but being here with you now, I don't know. I've needed someone like you in my life for a long time, Blue. I just never expected I'd actually get them. So thank you. For being the friend I can count on.
Prepare for friend zone. Wasn't sure if I should try it.
Like you're interested in becoming more than just friends.
Oh, Blue, I just don't know if I have room in my life for romance right now. Maybe for now we just stay friends.
Friend zone.
Now, what do you say we get moving?
I got the perk. That's all that matters. I'm in the friend zone. Friend zoned. I'm in the friend zone. Friend zoned. I'm in the friend zone. Friend zone city. Okay. Not much left to it now, folks. We'll pick this up in the next video. This is the Black Knight. You all have a great night. Oh, by the way, yeah, the Tama Toys factory right next to the huge mess that is Quincy Ruins. Look for that soon.
If it's not one thing, it's another. Well, gotta run.